My name is Frontier Setter, and this is the Ronin Tactics Task Force Belt. So, in short, it is a well-made, low-profile, sturdy belt able to hold your sidearm, mags, and other gear during various operations such as duty use, competition, or meme tier flex posting. Also, I cover some of the bits of kit I have used in this setup, including Mechanics Gloves, G-Code Softshell Scorpion Mag Caddies, Dark Angel IFAC, and Safariland ALS Holster. And the nice thing about having a belt like this is it takes weight off your chest or your shoulders depending on what other rigs that you might be wearing, so it divides up the weight that you're carrying. Now this one is specifically a two-layer design. The outside of the belt, as you can see here, is made up of hook Velcro. All along the belt it has PALS webbing for all your MOLLE gear and accessories. It also has this really robust D-ring on the Cobra buckle. The inner belt is loop Velcro. And how this works is you feed the inner belt through your belt loops like a standard belt, and then the outer one kind of ties in with the inner one. And by default, Ronin does give you an inner layer belt, however the inner belt is 2 inches wide. So if you're wearing civilian pants, you do need to buy their Ryu belt, which is their 1.5 inch belt, or if you were on a pinch, you can just buy a whatever cheapo Velcro belt, and that'll work well with this platform the same. The belt size is adjustable for the outer and inner belts, however they are not one size fits all. So you do have to measure waist correctly before you purchase one of these belts and make sure you do that right. So I have used previous belts in the past, but I really wasn't too fond of those because they weren't really secure onto your body. The nice thing about having two belt layers sandwiched in between your belt loops is that it really cinches the belt down to your waist and it doesn't bounce around at all, offering a very rigid, kind of stiff platform for all your stuff. Having a low profile belt like this is nice because it sits on the natural belt line. It's a very easy workspace, doesn't get in the way of your plate carrier or your chest rig, and it's comfortable because it feels like wearing a regular belt, just a little bit stiffer. One of the drawbacks of having this, as opposed to like a belt that you can just throw kind of around your hips and stuff, is that you do have to have, you know, obviously the inner belt woven through first and then having the outer belt. So you do have to kind of measure that out, that way it's a lot easier to don and doff. So taking a closer look, Ronin has used very high quality materials in making this belt. Ronin's gear is battle tested by not just meme tier operators like myself, but actual law enforcement, you know, military, all that stuff. This is battle proofing stuff. Very good. The PALS webbing throughout the belt is very, very tight. As you can see, there's no gaps in between the PALS webbing as you see when the belt is worn. So the way to get MOLLE gear inside is to actually inverse the belt, make little room for the PALS, and slip things through. The 2-inch Cobra buckle is also very heavy duty, and this is rated to be able to secure an operator on a helicopter or any kind of aerial aircraft. It's not used for rappelling, obviously it's not a harness system, but it can be used as your seatbelt or whatever. However, I don't see myself riding on any helicopter soon, so this does not apply to me, but I figured it would be nice to get this with the little D-ring keeper. This looks nice. Why not? So another thing to note is if you buy a solid colored belt, you will have a higher tensile strength of 7,000 pounds, whereas the ones that are multicolored, like this multicam one, the tensile strength is only 5,000 pounds. As with any high quality product, you do pay a very premium price. I bought this belt for around $187, not including the inner Ryu belt, but it is made in the USA, so it's one of those things you buy once, you cry once. So there are a couple competitors out there. I know there's Blue Alpha, they make a whole bunch of belts, as well as Blue Force Gear, they have their own belt, and I know Pharaoh Concepts recently released their Bison Belt, which is apparently even lower profile than this. It's around the same price point, has different features, but definitely something to take a look at if you are interested in this kind of setup. I have gone with the Mechanics Wear gloves. They're very popular. I just basically have these cinched on with a cheap Velcro carabiner I got on Amazon, and they're decent fit with good dexterity. My hands are kind of small, so I do wish they had a size that was like medium, you know, like in between small and medium, but these will do just fine. The smalls are like too tight, the mediums are a little bit too big, so I don't know. What can you do? For the Mag Caddies, I am using G-Code Scorpion Softshell Mag Caddies. They're very similar to like the S-Tech Kiwis, but I guess a little bit more modern. These are super well made, just like any other G-Code product. So these Mag Caddies are made with four specific parts. There's obviously the shock cord. The shock cord is to adjust your retention. There's a front and back. It's kind of like a rubbery layer, and that part kind of helps for retention. It's also waterproof and all that stuff. It's great. There is a plastic side and bottom piece that basically holds the shape of the mag so it doesn't collapse on itself. And that's really good for kind of reinsertion. And finally, the clips. So the clips I have here, I have this actually oriented upside down. And the reason for that is it drops the mag caddy's height a little bit lower. The clips are pretty heavy duty. They're kind of a pain in the ass to get in and out though. But once it's in and it's never coming out unless you really, really want it to. So if you are planning on weaving these clips onto the actual PALS webbing of your belt, like on the outside here, definitely get the P2 and R2 clip combination. So what that does, it's a thinner profile clip and doesn't impede on the Velcro layer inside. And also for my mag caddies, I decided to go with the short mag caddies for my pistol mags. The reason being the tall ones, if you're using compact mags, like the ones here, like 15 rounders or whatever for your Glocks or whatever gun, they might not fit in the long one, or it'll be really hard to kind of get to with your fingers. The next piece of kit I have here is this Dark Angel Medical Kit. This is a complete IFAC. It does come with shears, your tourniquet, and a whole bunch of goodies inside, including needle decompression, NPA, chest seals, all that good stuff. It's a complete IFAC, and it's really well thought out. And the nice thing about Dark Angel Medical is if you actually use any of these things for saving life or whatever, they will replace it for free. So it's like you buy a kit for life, essentially, from them, which is great. It is larger in size, though, which is a big issue. It does kind of, you know, it's molly webbing, so it fits on PALS just fine. Another big issue I have is that there is no dedicated quick release on this system. There's no like string that you can pull right away or Velcro. I don't know, maybe it belongs in like a backpack or something. I might throw this on my go bag instead. But how you deploy this kit, you pull this tab first, right? You pull that tab and inside is actually a vacuum sealed bag. And then you pull the smaller tab and then you open that up. And this is all your contents of your trauma kit. Everything is kind of wrapped around the chest seals here, and it works well. Is it a good IFAC? Is it very well thought out? Yes, but on a belt, I would consider something smaller. And something that I might look into for myself would be the Blue Force Gears Micro Trauma Kit. It's a very similar kit to this, but it is smaller. And the nice thing about that kit, it has a pull through. So it detaches quickly from your belt. That way you can use it if you really need it quickly. So moving on, this is a Safari 7377 ALS holster. This is for the Glock 19. It's really just a cheapo $35 holster I bought on Amazon to test the G19 out. Even though it's budget friendly, you know, I can't put a light on this or optics. It still has that Safari line quality on this. It's injection molded plastic, and it still has a really nice ALS quick release system here. ALS stands for auto locking system. So when you put your gun in, this tab on the inside actually locks within the ejection port of your gun. And you can't take this out until you decompress this little nub here with your thumb. It comes with a little mount on the back. It's rubbery, so you just feed it through any belt that you have and it cinches in just fine. There's no issues with this moving around at all, as you can see here. And the nice thing about Safariland is because they have so many holster types, you can change this out. So the system is quite modular. If you wanted a drop leg, you can customize it as you see fit here. So other considerations for this belt. So in the future, like I said before, I am gonna replace the IFAC either with a smaller one by Blue Force Gear or even just run a tourniquet. Cause usually when I go to the gun range, I already have a trauma kit in the car and stuff like that, or in my range bag. So it's like, do I really need to carry two or three of them with me all the time? It's good to have, but I don't think you really need it. So I might put in my Leatherman mutt onto this. And the mutt's a great multi-tool. I might review it later, I don't know. but it's kind of geared towards your rifle, so if you need to fix anything on the fly, you can. It has got a lot of tools, it's great. Very robust multi-tool there. I also might pick up a small dump pouch made by Blue First Gear. Now, I've had dump pouches in the past, but they've been kind of way too big. This one's like super micro, so it can just stick right next to my Mag Caddy here, and I don't have to worry about it. So the thing about these gun belts is even though you have a lot of real estate, you don't always want to deck the whole thing out in a bunch of gear. All in all, definitely highly recommend Ronin. Like I said before, very battle-proven design. So as you can see here, my personal setup is very, very simple. There's really no frills about this at all, but like I said, modularity gives you the chance to do whatever you want with these systems, so highly recommend getting a setup like this. It just helps with your training and all that stuff, and it's fun. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I answer to all the questions that I get in comments or whatever, so feel free to post. This is Frontier Setter. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Hope you learned something. If you haven't, I'm sorry. And always remember to stay tactically kawaii.